Morning and welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Wednesday, the 16th of October. We opened our worship this morning with a song by Keith and Kristen Getty entitled, Oh How Good It Is. Lo, fainter now lie spread the shades of night, and upward spread the trembling gleams of morn. Suppliant we bend before the Lord of light, and pray at early dawn, that this sweet charity may all our sin forgive, and make our miseries to cease. May grant us health, grant us the gift divine of everlasting peace. Father Supreme, this grace on us confer, and thou, O Son, by an eternal birth, with thee co-equal Spirit Comforter, whose glory fills the earth. Amen. We come now to this morning's reading, which continues our journey through the first letter of Paul to Timothy, and today we hear Chapter 4. Now the Spirit expressly says that in later times some will renounce the faith by paying attention to deceitful spirits and teachings of demons, through the hypocrisy of liars whose consciences are seared with a hot iron. They forbid marriage and demand abstinence from foods which God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and who know the truth. For everything created by God is good, and nothing is to be rejected, provided it is received with thanksgiving, for it is sanctified by God's word and by prayer. If you put these instructions before the brothers and sisters, you will be a good servant of Christ Jesus, nourished on the words of the faith and of the sound teaching that you have followed. Have nothing to do with profane myths and old wives' tales. Train yourself in godliness, for while physical training is of some value, godliness is valuable in every way, holding promise for both the present life and the life to come. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, for to this end we toil and struggle, because we have our hope set on the living God, who is the Saviour of all people, especially of those who believe. These are the things you must insist on and teach. Let no one despise your youth, but set the believers an example in speech and conduct, in love, in faith, in purity. Until I arrive, give attention to the public reading of Scripture, to exhorting, to teaching. Do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you through prophecy with the laying on of hands by the council of elders. Put these things into practice, devote yourself to them so that all may see your progress. Pay close attention to yourself and to your teaching. Continue in these things, for in doing this you will save both yourself and your hearers. Thanks be to God. And now our reflection. What is the domain of the Christian? What is his or her area of interest and investment? It is not a narrow one. We are not to concern ourselves not only with some specifically Christian subset of the life of the world. We read in Philippians that we are to be occupied in mind and action by whatever is true, honourable, just, pure, pleasing, commendable, excellent and praiseworthy. It is therefore no rejection of the faith to recognize and celebrate all that is good in what God has created, wherever it is to be found. All such things like food and marriage mentioned in the passage today are to be received and recognized in a Christian way, with word and prayer, with reflection and with thankfulness. Nothing is to be rejected, provided it is received with thanksgiving. That is not a recipe for immorality, nor is it a get-out-of-jail-free card that excuses us from spiritual discernment. But it is a reminder of that great Pauline theme of freedom and of the great biblical teaching that God's creation is good. Everything created by God is good, with a goodness that might be defaced by sin, but is never erased. Amen. We join together now in the Lord's Prayer, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Circle us, Lord. Keep strife without, keep peace within. Keep fear without, keep hope within. Keep pride without, keep trust within. Keep harm without, keep good within. May we walk in the hope of your kingdom, and so fill us with your light and love, that we know that you are with us all through this day, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, help us to use honestly and well this day all the talents which you have given us, that the gain may not be ours only, but yours and your kingdom's. Through Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen.